My name is Jorja Smith and I'm from Warsaw in the West Midlands. At school, I mean, about how I looked, sometimes I was a bit insecure. And also I went to school with like predominantly white girls, so I kind of like wanted to look like everyone else, but I didn't. But now I'm cool. Blue lights into strobe lights, maybe even fairy lights, now blue flashing lights. I've been singing like forever. My mum said I would always make noise, like when I was younger. Maybe even fairy lights. I learned keyboard when I was 8. And when I was 11, I wrote my first song. I got into my secondary school on a music scholarship, meaning like I had to be in the choir and I had to learn a new instrument. And we did like music 3 times a week instead of like one. Don't you run when you hear the sirens coming? When you hear the sirens coming, you better not run with the sirens. I was confident singing, but I used to stand still. Now I like move around. But before I just used to like stand in the same place. But I'd never done much performing, so. I think it just grows with you the more you do it. You apologize, was the harm in there? Not much has changed how I write. I think it's the fact that I'm growing up, I'm experiencing more, I'm learning more things, so I have more to write about, like maybe from my own experiences. Before I used to kind of write from like observation or like conversation with people. I still do that now. But now I can write about love and know what I'm talking about, whereas before I never did, I just imagined. Two black shadow as you're getting off the bus, shadow shows no emotions, or what's even the fuss, but the I was doing my coursework for media when I was 17. I had to make a documentary. And I did Peace versus Grime. Within my documentary, I was interviewing kids at school from like 11 to 17, asking them what they thought of the police. There was this group of black boys in year 7. I asked them, oh, watching the police, and they were all like, you know, I hate the police, they're always after us, they're always onto us. And I was like, what have you done? They're like, nothing. So I was like, okay, that's interesting. You got blood on your hands, but you don't know where it's from. They came to my house, the Sea Boys, and he left his pouch at mine. And I'm really nosy. So I looked in there and there was a knife in there and it was like a flicky one. And I got it out and I didn't know how to put it back. Like YouTubed how to put down this knife. Put it back, cleaned it, gave him his belt back, never said anything. So then all these things are just in my head and my dad told me to take a break from writing this essay. So then I kind of was thinking about my 2 friends who had the knife and I was like thinking about a story about them. And then that's how I wrote Blue Lights. Blue lights are just passing by. My song Teenage Fantasy, and I wrote that when I was 16, I was babysitting. And like people that are like a lot older than me can relate to that. So I think I'm quite good at just writing for everyone. Maybe this fate was overdue. My debut album is called Lost and Found. The reason it was called that is because I kept going back to Lost and Found, that was track one. And I just thought, when I listen to the album, it does make me think of being lost and found, because I feel like the track listing just makes you go on a, like, a little journey with me. And I think it sums up me. Anyone that knows me knows I get lost quite easily, like in loads of things, but then I know exactly what I want to do at the same time. So where did I go? When did the sun rise? How did I fall? Got lost in the moonlight. Where did I go? I want to write more songs because I've been performing loads and haven't really written that much and I miss doing that, so I just want to write. I do have some shows, but writing is my main thing that I want to do. Goodbye, goodbye, yeah. The way I want people to perceive me is that I'm honest. Goodbye. I just know I'm me. That's it.
Thank you.